Now in this video, we'll discuss about the state of a system. What do we understand by the process and what do we understand by the cycle? Okay. Now let's start by understanding the state of a system. Now state of a system can only be understood if you understand what is the property of a system. Okay. So for that we have drawn you can say two axes. The vertical axis, let us say, defines or plots a property which is the pressure of the system, and the horizontal axis plots the volume of the system. Alright, let us say you have a pressure P1 over here and a volume V1 over here. So at this particular point, let me name this point as 1. So this is point 1. At point 1, the physical condition of the system is defined by the property P1 and property V1. So the pressure of the system is P1 and the volume is V1. Okay. So when the condition of a system is defined by its properties, that condition is called the state of the system. So in this, 1 is the state of the system. Alright. So if you define the state of a system, you can say the physical condition, which is defined by, the system properties. Okay. So to define a system, or you can say to define a state, you have to have the system properties defined before that. Okay, so this becomes the state of the system. Now, for example, let me define one more state. Let me define this as P2 and this as volume V2. Now, so this is state 2. Okay, so at state 2, the pressure is P2 and the volume is V2. So now, if you talk about the two states, so now we are talking about a single system. This is the state of, you can say, the system that we have, and this is the another state of the system that we have. Now, how did your system reach from state 1 to state 2? In reaching from state 1 to state 2, a system would have followed a certain process. Okay, so let us say that process is this. This is the process that the system followed in moving from state 1 to state 2. It can be any process. Okay, so when there is a state change, we call a process has occurred. And in that state change, there may be a change of the state variables. That is the properties of the system. Okay, so at state 1, the state variables are P1 and V1. At state 2, the state variables are P2 and V2. So in changing the state from P1 to from 1 to 2, the pressure value changes from P1 to P2 and the volume changes from V1 to V2. So in a process, the state changes and also there is a change in the state variables. Okay. So to define that what a process is, a process occurs if there is a state change. Okay. And in a state change, there are property changes as well. Alright. So we have understood what is the state of a system, we have understood what is the process, that is a state change, and we now focus our attention to what is a cycle. Okay. Now cycle is linked to process. So let's build a chain out of it. State is, or you can say process, comes from the understanding of the state of a system. Cycle comes from the understanding of the process. Okay. So whenever there is a state change happening, there will be a process happening. Okay. Now, from state 1 to state 2, you have a process. That is 1, 2. Okay. So this process is 1, 2. Now, if somehow, I don't know how, let's not go into that right now, but somehow I come back from state 2 to state 1. Okay, so I am coming back from state 2 to state 1. Now this process is called 2-1. This is process 2-1. Okay, now what is happening? Let's ignore 2-1 for the moment. Let's come to the original part. So when you were moving from 1 to 2, the initial state was 1 and the final state was 2. Now what we are doing, we are going from 1, then we stop for a moment at 2, and then from 2 we come back to 1. So this is the complete process. The process does not stop at state 2. It stops at state 1. So in this particular process, the initial state and the final state, they are identical. Now, so in this process, that is 1, 2, and then from 2, 1. So this is the entire process. The initial state and the final states are identical. So in such a process where the initial and the final states are identical, that is called a cycle. So to define a cycle, so cycle is basically a process. What kind of process is it? It is a process in which initial and final states are identical. Final states are identical. Okay, so this is a very, very important topic to understand. I would say three topics: state, process, and cycle. And before that, you should be very, very comfortable by understanding of the property of a system. So I hope you understood that what is the property of a system, what is the state of a system, what is the process, and what is the cycle. Now, in the next video, we talk about two kinds of functions. We talk about path function, and then we talk about point functions. Now let's go and talk about these two kinds of functions in the next video.